Can anyone provide permanent stability to this world? Can anyone supply permanent security to this world? Can anyone supply permanent happiness to this world? If there's no stability, can there be security? No security, can there be happiness? So if there's no permanence to any of that, can this feeling of constant impermanence, can that satisfy us? A pilgrim once went on a long journey to see a great guru. And they arrived there and the guru said yes. And the pilgrim says, "Guru, I really have one thing I want you to do for me, to make me happy." And the guru says, "Okay, what is it?" And the pilgrim showed the guru their feet, which was all bloody, bruised mess, horrible. And the pilgrim says, "You know, look what happened to me on my long journey to see you. I would like you to remove all the stickers and the thorns and the little pebbles that have ruined my feet on the way to see you." And the guru said, "Well, I can do that for you." And the pilgrim says, "Wow, tremendous. You're such an all-powerful, miraculous guru. Okay." And the guru says, "Okay, next time you come to see me, wear a pair of shoes." In other words, if you want the troubles of existence to vanish for you, then choose another idea. It's that simple. And we all know that this is the answer, and yet we are hedging our bets, and we're maintaining our fixation with the idea of existence because we think that maybe we can find some force, some way to force stability on existence, some way to force security, some way to force happiness, force that to be permanent. We're looking for that forcefulness, some way to accomplish it. And we believe that it's always right around the corner. It's almost there. The research is taking place. The wheels are in motion. The prayers are going up to God to accomplish this. And we will find a way. So we're looking at that and saying, "Will it happen? Will it happen? Will it happen?" And that maintains our fixation on this one idea of existence to the exclusion of all other ideas. We will freely admit that it hasn't yet happened. But we say, "But it will soon. It will soon. We're almost there. Almost there." We spend a lifetime of almost theirs. And then we find out that even death isn't permanent. And we end up spending another lifetime of almost theirs. Perhaps the greatest shock anyone can experience in existence is to realize that death itself isn't permanent, and that you get a return ticket here. And when you see that, and you know it for 100% fact, that causes absolute revolution in your belief system. And you realize, "I can't even count on death to end this misery, this feeling of impermanence. It too is impermanent. What to do now?" And eventually you get around to remembering, all I have to do is choose a new idea, just like that pilgrim. All they had to do was put on a pair of shoes. No more bruises, no more stickers or thorns. They arrive there and their feet are fine. It's that simple. If the truth be told, many are trying to make their death permanent. They're hoping that this dying that they're going to undertake will make it permanent. And then that sense of permanence will somehow magically force upon the idea of impermanence, a sense of permanence, and that somehow that will bring the happiness beyond the grave. It's not true. You get a return ticket and you keep going around and around and around. And yet as long as one is frantically engaged in this effort to find permanence within the effects of the idea of existence, one will not want to hear the truth that there is no way to force it upon existence. Existence will remain impermanent. Even your efforts to force it will become impermanent. You won't maintain that constantly. And to those engaged in this effort, it will, at a point, seem to be just completely impossible. A feeling of just complete impossibility. And despair. Yes, it is impossible, but there's no reason to despair, because all you have to do is choose a new idea. Just like the pilgrim, all they had to do, put on a new pair of shoes, or any pair of shoes. Doesn't even have to be new, or a pair of sandals. Very simple. No reason to despair. If they find out that the guru cannot remove all the stickers and thorns and pebbles from all the pathways in the entire globe, should they despair? Or should they just put on a pair of shoes? Very simple. So as we find our pathways strewn with these terrible stickers and thorns and obstacles now, should we really despair? Or should we remember, all I have to do is to choose a new idea, and everything will be fine. Now there is an idea which will allow all the stickers and the thorns and the obstacles to remain on the path there, and yet you will not feel them, they will not trouble you. There is such an idea. It's the idea of not trying to replace reality with a new reality. Because existence is the idea of trying to replace reality with a new reality. And by choosing the idea of not trying to replace reality with a new reality, that's like putting on a pair of shoes. A feeling arises that proves to you you're not trying to accomplish the impossible. Everything that arises then, everything will still be there, the thorns and stickers, but you won't feel them. You'll see it in a different light. You'll feel it in a different light. You'll experience it in a different light, as if they're not touching this feeling at all. So you don't have to find a great miracle worker somewhere up in the Himalayas or on the Gangetic Plain. Wherever the great miracle workers are supposed to hang out, all you have to do is just remember, I am spirit. God, the prime creator, created me with full capacity and authority to choose any idea I want to choose at any moment. I'm never bound to any idea from moment to moment to moment. I am free. I will always be free. Therefore, all I have to do is choose a new idea. Simple, easy, no trouble at all. And maybe we're waiting for some encounter that will suddenly, shed a light on it all. But it's so simple, do we really need that? Just a simple remembrance of what our true capacity really is. Sure, sometimes encounters can help, but you shouldn't sit there and say, I'm hopeless, I'm helpless, if I don't have some special event take place. No, every single moment you have the complete capacity and authority to choose a new idea, to put on that pair of shoes. It's easy. Now, in hearing this, do we do it? Probably not. Does that mean we've defaulted then and we no longer have the capacity? No. Capacity was always there. Moment by moment by moment will always be there for eternity, endlessness. So it doesn't matter how many times you shrink back from it, decide you want to keep on with this idea of existence. You can do that too. But you will still have the capacity and authority every single moment, moment by moment. Nothing can interfere with that. You can choose a new idea any moment at all. If it's not this one, it could be the next one, or the next one, or the next one, or whenever. Not a trouble, not a problem. And all have equal capacity to do this. Equal capacity, equal authority. There's no such thing as aspects of spirit that are special, have some kind of greater capacity or authority to choose a new idea. All have this equal capacity and authority, moment by moment by moment. Very simple. So take a few moments right now just to remember this. That's all that's required. Just remember this. Very good. That's it.